Hannah is your host, let's go. If you wanna be in the know, in the spotlight is where to go. Industry celebrities of every kind. Teresa Hannah is your host, let's go. In the spotlight, the spotlight, the spotlight, the spotlight, in the spotlight, the spotlight, with Teresa Hannah. Hannah is your host, let's go. If you wanna be in the know, in the spotlight is where to go. Industry celebrities of every kind. Teresa Hannah is your host, let's go. In the spotlight, the spotlight, the spotlight, the spotlight, in the spotlight, the spotlight, with Teresa Hannah.
I'm so excited you're in the spotlight with Teresa Hannah on the Source Radio Television Network. We are the Source, that's right, primary number one radio television network in the world. And we're so happy that you have joined me, your host, Teresa Hannah, right here in our studios in Atlanta for this very special show. My heart is on fire today because I have a very, very, very important and special guest in the spotlight with me, Teresa Hannah. I'm putting in the spotlight my very own beloved sorority, Sigma Gamma Rho, and my very own beloved president, international grand bachelor, Deborah Catchings-Smith. So first I want to say some things to you because we really want you to know about the love of our life, Sigma Gamma Rho, before my husband, before I fell in love with him, Larry Hannah, I fell in love with Sigma Gamma Rho at Alpha Beta at Tennessee State University. Okay, so I'm going to tell you this before we hear Deborah's voice. Sigma Gamma Rho is a member of the Divine Nine, the Paneletic Council. It was founded in 1922 at Butler University. And we're actually involved in social causes that impact not only our nation, but the whole world. That's right, the total world, and involving a wide range of programs, including Act Against AIDS, Buckle Up America, the National Maradona Program. This is only a few. But now under the fresh and focused leadership of International Grand Bachelor's President, my Sara, my beloved Sara, Deborah Catchings-Smith, Sigma Gamma Rho is now well-positioned to seize the countless opportunities and to face any and every challenge. She is here with me in the spotlight on Source Radio Television Network to talk about Sigma Gamma Rho's platforms for change, to bring her fresh ideas and fresh perspective to the work of this great sorority as it approaches its centennial celebration in 2022. We're going to be talking about all that. But right now, let's greet my Sara, President, International Grand Bachelor of Sigma Gamma Rho, Sara Deborah Catchings-Smith. How are you, Sara?
I am great. I am great, Sara Hannah. So wonderful to be on this network with you.
Wonderful, wonderful. We're going to get started because I know that you are a busy lady. You're away taking care of sorority business, and we're going to talk a little bit about that. But first, tell Source Nation, my audience, what we do, who we are as a sorority. What is Sigma Gamma Rho today?
Surely. Thank you again for this great opportunity to share some information about our phenomenal sisterhood. As you mentioned earlier in your introduction, of course, we've been in this space since November 12, 1922, founded on a predominantly and historically white institution, College Kansas.
That's right.
In the 20s, when our fearless seven founders decided that they wanted to make an impact in the communities, to provide education, scholarship, and opportunities for young people, and to really enhance the quality of life of families and children. And with that, our fearless founders were in the face of tumultuous times in the 20s. As you can all imagine, in the 20s, our world was very different. And to add to that, the organization was founded in a place where the national headquarters of the Ku Klux Klan resided. Literally, Butler University was down the street from the world headquarters of the Ku Klux Klan, where they call it Grand Dragon, where that individual resided and worked out of. So you can't tell me how fearless. We have such a fearless legacy of leadership with our founders that has continued on through today.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Simply wonderful, wonderful. You know, I want to add also that Sigma Gamma Rho is the international service organization comprised of women from every profession, that also that Sigma Gamma Rho offers its members opportunities to develop their unique talents through leadership, training, and involvement in sorority activities, offering friendships and professional contacts. You want to comment also on that, Clara?
Yes, absolutely. We have a wide spectrum of diverse women that are affiliated with our phenomenal sisterhood. We start, of course, at the beginning, which is the college initiates, the college level undergraduates, all the way through our alumni chapters that exist today. We have countries not only, or actually chapters, not only in the United States, but also outside of the U.S. We have chapters in the Bermuda, Bahamas,
yes.
Chapters in Jamaica, Korea, Germany, Canada. So we are a very, very wide-spanning organization reaching outside the borders of this country. And we are also proud that we have two affiliate organizations as well. One is called the Philo Affiliates, which is an organization of women who are non-degreed, who are supporters of our sisterhood as it relates to all of our community service initiatives, as well mm-hmm. as providing scholarship funding to support our young people. And then we have a youth group called ROARS, which are high school girls. And those high school girls are our mentees. And we, of course, provide much support and opportunities for sharing and learning as well as scholarships with our ROARS. They actually travel with us to our regional and national conventions, you know, kind of mm-hmm. exposing our young women to leadership, excellence, opportunities to give back to their communities, respective communities across the country. And then the third affiliate group that we just brought on within the last year are called Rosebuds,
okay.
which are
wow.
younger little girls that started 8 years of age. And so many of our local chapters have initiated and activated our Rosebuds. And again, you know, we can't start early enough with embracing our young women, talking about self-confidence, you know, issues that they're facing nowadays that most
Absolutely.
Of us young adults or adults would never even have imagined, anti-bullying situations, and just really giving, again, that eye-opening experience to a whole new world beyond their local communities and helping to mentor and shape and support their families in that effort.
Oh, this is beautiful, beautiful. Ladies, even young girls, you have a chance to grow with Sigma Gamma Rho.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
That's wonderful. Yes. You know, Sigma Gamma Rho has just some great platforms to serve, and I'm going to name, I think, at least five of them. There are so many of them. But as I name them, Sarah Smith, I just want you to comment. The first is the National Education Fund. What is it and what does it do for Sigma Gamma Rho?
Yes. The National Education Fund is an arm of the organization, primarily focused on educational opportunities and providing scholarships. The scholarships are open not only to women, but also to men. And so each
wow.
year, the National Education Fund, yeah, a lot of people would think it would only be siloed to women.
But ladies,
no, we
yes.
recognize. Mm-hmm. We recognize.
I
we also
told,
need to support our men.
That you are wonderful, and we are.
Yes. So each year, the National Education Fund awards scholarships to women and men across the country at various institutions and providing some financial assistance so that they can continue their education on through, you know, not only undergraduate but also postgraduate scholarships are available as well through the National Education Fund.
It's all that information found on our national website where people can go in, young ladies and men, to apply for those education funds.
Yes, actually what happens when you go to our national website, which is www.sgrho1922.org, it will take you to then the National Education Fund, and from there when you click on that link, it takes you directly to the website specifically for the National Education Fund and the scholarship opportunities. And scholarships open up every April 1st of every year. And so we are mm-hmm. just so excited that we have that opportunity to share again and give back to our respective communities, providing financial resources, which are much needed. We all know now about the college debt that our young people are facing is just horrendous.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
we are definitely doing our part to help reduce the amount of debt that is experienced by college students.
Wonderful, wonderful. We encourage all the students listening that they will hit our Sigma Gamma Rho website and go ahead and apply for those wonderful scholarships. The second one I wanted you to comment on and tell us about is one that I am just simply in awe of. I love it because it's here. It's called the Seven Pearls Foundation.
Yes, so the Seven Pearls Foundation is also an arm of our sisterhood. And that particular foundation was formulated to support our national headquarters, which is located in Cary, North Carolina. It's a wonderful mm-hmm. facility, a multi-million dollar facility. And that foundation helped support that particular arm of the organization, as well as they, too, are involved in some philanthropic areas around breast cancer, heart health, wellness, which we know, again, that's one of the disparities in the African-American community specific to women is the rate of heart attacks that we are suffering and dying at an early age. And so that is another area of focus of the give back through the Seven Pearls Foundation as well.
Okay, and also I think they have just had a recent event that was a luncheon for Seven Pearls. It just sold out, didn't it?
It did. So they also support our life members. The life members is a membership classification within our sisterhood based on your level of commitment and connection with the organization. And so at that particular luncheon that we held during our national convention, which is called the Boule, about 2 weeks ago, that was held in Dallas, Texas, the Seven Pearls Foundation also sponsored a life member luncheon, which they do every year at our national conventions. And again, just celebrating the commitment of the membership who have committed to lifetime, you know, dedication and service to the organization, whether it be through, of course, sweat equity, but also through financial support.
Wonderful, wonderful. Okay, number three, Sigma Public Education and Research Foundation. I think we call it SPEAR.
Yes, SPEAR, the third arm of the organization. And SPEAR, primary focus is on supporting our chapters within the organization to find funding and partnerships for the various community service projects. And so SPEAR helps to provide that knowledge base, the resource for our local chapters across the country to be able to connect with SPEAR and get some assistance in, you know, what's available through grants and other funding foundations to support local programming and our community service efforts.
Wonderful, wonderful. What would be an example of some of the things that this foundation does?
So an example of that would be something along the lines of our Operation Big Book Bag and providing chapters with some funding, corporate sponsorship opportunities for that particular initiative. And then those funds would be used to support the purchase of school supplies that would be donated to our children in local communities.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. All right, now we have Souls for Little Souls. I just love that. What is that about?
That, again, is a program sponsored by SPEAR Foundation.
And it is a program that I believe that collects and distributes shoes to students. Is that correct?
Yes, that is correct.
Okay, we're going to move on to Leadership Development Empowering Sisters. What is that about?
Leadership Development Empowerment is just ensuring that our members and our chapters always have the opportunity to learn and grow in the various activities that they're engaged in. We have local leadership on the chapter level, of course, the regional level, and then the international level. So we always want to be sure that we're providing adequate training and resources to support and build up women leaders within our sisterhood.
Amazing, amazing, amazing. You know, when I was pledging at Alpha Beta at Tennessee State University, this motto was I had to go to bed with it and I had to rise in the morning with it. Greater service, greater progress. And that's us in a nutshell for me, you know, in terms of Sigma Gamma Rho. That's just so wonderful. So we offer so many services. You had mentioned like the Operation Big Book Bag, but I want all of Source Nation to know all the wonderful things that we are doing as a social sorority. Tell us a little bit about the Operation Big Book Bag and even the We Savers.
Okay, so Operation Big Book Bag is an opportunity to provide much-needed school supplies and resources, as well as book bags, to children in the local communities. But it also has a mentorship component where members are engaged in tutoring opportunities, mentoring, going into the school districts across the country and providing that support to our young people.
Okay, and this is for at-risk children, homeless children, and even children in extended care, correct?
That is correct. It's all children. It covers the gamut.
Great.
Absolutely.
Great. What is our little We Savers program about?
Now, the We Savers program is actually a component of the Spear Foundation, and I do know that that particular program is focused on financial literacy, which is so important nowadays. What is a credit score? Opening your own bank account. What does it mean to have
wow.
a bank account to live by? So it's really basic financial literacy skills that we are teaching young people as well as adults, because adults need that assistance as well.
That's right. And then we move down to Project Reassurance, and then I want you to also comment on Habitat for Humanity.
Okay. Project Reassurance is really an umbrella component of several aspects of our sisterhood. It's really about making healthy choices, making healthy decisions, healthy living, and then for us to effectuate healthy generations, people in our generations beyond us. And so there are several programs under the actual Project Reassurance. There is, of course, within Project Reassurance, we're looking at our March of Dimes focus with our partnership.
Oh, yes.
Which, of course,
yes.
is all about young babies and mothers and preventing premature birth, which is at a very high rate in the African-American community as well as communities of color. And then we are also engaged in our St. Jude partnership, which, again, is fighting against cancer, childhood cancer. We have a long partnership there as well. And then our Swim 1922 initiative, which is a fairly new program we brought on about 6 years ago now, and we are seeing phenomenal results with. And that is our drowning prevention effort in the African-American community and communities of color, and providing
wow.
free swim clinics in partnership with USA Swimming across the country to expose our young people. It's tackling several things. It's tackling the fear of water. It's tackling, again, drowning prevention, and it's also
mm-hmm.
tackling obesity, overall health mm-hmm. and wellness by getting in the water, and it's exposing our community to another sport and some Olympians who are actually African-American. So really dispelling the myth that black people don't get in the water and black people don't swim.
Much needed, much needed. I know that SARAs have been involved in Habitat for Humanity. What have we been doing there?
Well, our ties with Habitat really fell under an administration several years ago. Past Grand Ambassador was Corrine Green, who was from the West Coast, and back in the 90s, and we actually built several homes during her administration. After that, there has still continued to be some level of support with local chapters being engaged with Habitat for Humanity and donating their time and effort on not only building homes, but also home buyer education for new homeowners, because there is definitely a lot to learn if you become a homeowner. It's not the same as when you were a tenant and, you know, could just pick up the
right.
phone and call the landlord because the plumbing's not working. Now you're the plumber.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very different.
All these wonderful things that we're doing, greater service, great progress that we're doing in America. Tell us about Project Africa and are there other projects that are international that we're involved in?
So Project Africa is basically a component of, again, teaching our historical reference to the continent of Africa, all the wealth and beauty that it has to offer, sharing that information with our young people as well as our adults, and making sure that we are ever mindful of our history. And so that's what Project Africa is about.
All right, all right. Source Nation, Sigma Gamma Rho, our slogan, of course, greater service, greater progress, our colors, royal blue, gold, our flower is the beautiful yellow tea rose. Our official publication, of course, is the Aurora. We have over 600 chapters. And some of the nicknames that we use, Lady Sigmas, I love that, Sigmas, or SG Rose. And I just wanted to interject these little things to know about the love of my life, Sigma Gamma Rho. Hi. Sarah, I wanted to take this time, too, to just call off and name some of the brave women who founded our sorority, Sigma Gamma Rho. Of course, was organized November 12, 1922, in Indianapolis, Indiana, by seven young educators. And like you said earlier, they founded it at a time when the Ku Klux Klan were very strong. It was in their heyday, you know, when they had a stranglehold, especially in the South. And, you know, also I want to interject, too, that for some reason the Lord had allowed me and my husband to buy a home in Pulaski, Tennessee, where Pulaski is the city that began the Ku Klux Klan. The originals were here. The original founders were here. But things have really changed over the years. But I kind of want to give honor to Mary Lou, Allison Gardner Little, Dorothy Hanley Whiteside. These are our founders, Vivian White Marbury, Nanny Mae Gon Johnson, Hattie Mae Annette Doolin Redford, Bessie Mae Downey Rhodes Martin, and Tabina McClure. This group became a collegiate sorority on December 30, 1929, when a chapter was granted to Alpha Chapter at Butler University. So, Sarah, if you want to comment anything about our founders at this time, I'd love to have you do that.
Yes, absolutely. Our founders were great, visionary, empowered, fearless, you know, women. They actually did great work in organizing our sisterhood. And here we are, you know, just only four short years away from approaching our centennial of the of this amazing organization. And our founders have left a, you know, indelible footprint across the world, you know, in so many areas, whether it's political, entertainment, education, social action. They have really have been the drivers for the path that we are now blessed to be able to follow based on what they started in 1922.
All right. I've got something special coming up. You know, we have a special Sarah that happens to be an R&B sensation. She is the queen of R&B soul. And we're going to dedicate Kelly Price's song. It's called Sister to our founders. Let's take a listen right now.
La, la, la. She raised alone, 'cause he is flirting with danger and it's getting close, but he won't listen. She prays to God and asked him, would you please protect him? But she is not alone. Young girl is lying about the weight she's gaining, because she is hiding a baby that her boyfriend says he didn't father. He said he was in love, but now he can't be bothered. But keep your head up high, little sister.
Sister, don't have to cry. Everything will be alright, my sister. You don't have to weep, 'cause things are getting better. Sister, you don't have to cry. Everything will be alright, my sister. You don't have to weep, 'cause things are getting better.
At night the bills are piling, patience low and precious high, and you can't take it. You say you'll just throw up your hands, but you can't make it. Somebody understands.
Yeah.
right, we're back, and you're in the spotlight with Teresa Hannah, and it's all about Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority and our international grand basileus, Deborah Catchings-Smith. And we just heard a wonderful song, a beautiful song called Sisters by our sorority sister, Kelly Price. So now I wanted to just share a little bit about my beloved Sarah, Deborah Catchings-Smith. She's the one who is bringing that fresh and focused platform for change. She's a banking executive. She was recently elected to a two-year term as International Grand Basileus or President of Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority. She is also Vice President, Operational Risk Management Governance at Citibank in St. Louis, Missouri. And, of course, she brings more than 27 years of financial industry experience to the role. And in short, my Sarah is a very smart lady, and I love her. I am so excited, too, because now through your leadership and others who are in the leadership capacity at Sigma Gamma Rho, you have a great team. And now I know that we are well positioned to seize these countless opportunities. And I want to kind of let you share with us some of the ideas or the plans that you have for Sigma Gamma Rho or that you have instituted into our great sorority.
Sure, and thank you. I first need to say, Sarah Hannah, I love you as well. And again, I appreciate such this wonderful opportunity to share knowledge about our phenomenal sisterhood. Sigma Gamma Rho actually is such in a great position, knowing that what we have been focusing on past 2 years and what we will continue to focus on, given my blessing of being reelected just a few weeks ago to another two-year term.
Yay!
Yes. Is to continue to demonstrate the great work and the great impact that we are producing and that we are really changing lives. And I think that is an area where we have great opportunity. We began a more of a dynamic focus on 2 years ago. That focus will continue, and that is to ensure that we are intentional about everything that we do. We stop and take a pause, and we make sure that what the programs are that we are delivering to our various communities, the activities we're engaged in on a local, regional, national level, that they have impact, that can be documented, and we know exactly what our outcomes are. And I think that is a challenge not only for Sigma Gamma Rho, but any service-focused organization. You know, our stakeholders want to know, well, show us a cause and effect here and show us the outcomes. And so we have really been focusing on that the last 2 years and will continue to focus more diligently on those efforts to be able to document and demonstrate what we're doing and how we are positively impacting our communities. We are literally saving lives with so many of our programs and initiatives. And to be able to tell our own story about what we're doing and what we are accomplishing, not just for story, you know, telling sake, but to uplift others and to empower our
community. Yes, that's what it's all about. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Is that also a part of the work for Going for Sigma Gold?
Now, Going for Sigma Gold is our national strategic plan, and that was created in 2015 under the immediate past Grand Basileus prior to me, Sora Benita Herring. And Sora Benita Herring, you know, started to create and develop the plan, and my administration has been carrying through on that strategic plan. And, again, it's basically back to what I just mentioned about being more strategic and more focused on our community engagement and our outcomes and being very intentional about making the best choices for each engagement that we have, each activity or each program, if you will, that we take on, because right now there is such an outcry in our communities that we can't afford to waste time. Our communities need us now more than ever. So we have
to be
very clear about that we're meeting the needs. And a program that we may have completed or done 10 years ago may not be relevant today. So we have to make sure we're always mindful of addressing the needs of our communities. With that strategic plan, we're also focusing on how to enhance and uplift our own internal sisterhood and providing, again, back to your earlier question, leadership training opportunities and kind of amping that up, the level of engagement that we're having across that space, as well as working with all of our membership about a strategic plan for focus on membership recruitment, retention, and reactivation within our system as well. So that plan is very encompassing. It's a very broad depth of what we need to do and focus on as we lead into our centennial.
Yes, wonderful, awesome. Let me ask you this because I'm curious too. What is the best part of being a leader in Sigma Gamma Rho?
The best part is to be able to share our story. It really is. And the amazing work that our sisterhood is engaged in. It is just phenomenal. It is unmatched. And I'm not saying that because I'm a member of Sigma Gamma Rho. I may be a little biased. However,
I think we are.
But the fact is, we are literally changing lives by the activities we're engaged in. I can tell you as an example, one of the actual community service initiatives, the SWIM 1922, is our drowning prevention initiative. And that initiative that just came on board 6 years ago has gotten us world acclaim, and I mean that literally.
Wow.
Because other organization, no other service organization, whether it be Greek or non-Greek, has tackled the drowning rate like Sigma Gamma Rho. And we're actually seeing impacts with that. And we are the record that speaks to the impacts. So we are just so honored. I'm honored to be able to represent this amazing sisterhood and the work that's being accomplished across all of our platforms, whether it be undergraduate, alumni members, all of our affiliates. We're just doing amazing work. So that's
greater
that's
service, greater progress.
Absolutely.
Okay.
We walk the talk. We walk the talk. We just don't talk about service. We're actually doing the work.
We're doers.
Yes, we're doers.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, and we're looking for more doers. So if you're out there,
absolutely.
We need you. We want you. Yes, we do. My daughter's raising her hand. I think we're recruiting.
Wonderful.
Okay. All right. Sara Kelly Price has a song called It's My Time. And Sara Smith, I just feel like this is your time, my time, our time at Sigma Gamma Rho. So with that being said, let's listen to our Sara Kelly Price.
Hey. 1, 2, 1, 2. Time has come out.
in the spotlight with Teresa Hannah, and you just heard a wonderful song by my Sarah Kelly Price, international R&B artist that everybody knows and loves, and we want everybody to know that she is a Sigma Gamma Rho. There are just so many wonderful people out there who are our Sarahs. I know that we can't even name them all. It's just so many, right, Sarah?
Yes, there are so many amazing women who have joined just our wonderful sisterhood. Yes.
Yes, yes. I want to talk a little bit now about going for Sigma Go. Can you tell us a little bit about what its focus is? Who will it benefit? Sarah, tell us about that.
Yes, going for Sigma Gold is our strategic plan, and we have been working through that strategic plan since it was started in 2015. And again, it's all about having that laser focus on community service, our outreach, being intentional, making sure that we can measure our impacts and outcomes, and making sure that we are meeting the needs of our communities. And then the other component is education to our members, leadership opportunities, providing that uplift and support for women in general, and making sure that we are also providing the members with opportunities to learn and grow. And then the third component is ensuring that we are providing the tools and resources to assist all of our chapters with recruitment activities, retaining their current membership, and also reactivation of any members. And so it's very, very comprehensive, and the focus of this administration, making sure that we're following our own strategic plan.
Wonderful, wonderful, excellent, excellent. Sara Smith, the one thing that I really want to get in right now, I want you to focus with us on Sigma Gamma Rho Centennial Celebration in 2022. Tell us about it.
Absolutely, absolutely. So the Sisterhood of Amazing Women will converge in Indianapolis, Indiana, which is the birthplace of our organization, because that is where Butler University is located today. And we will all convene in Indianapolis, Indiana in July of 2022, which will be the centennial celebration of our sisterhood. We have a really dynamic national centennial committee that is working on all of the activities and events that are going to occur to honor our sisterhood and our founders. And that national committee has been working now for the past few years and continues to do their work. We have been also tracking against several goals around the centennial, where we want to see ourselves when 2022 arrives. And most of it is directly tied to the strategic plan, the Going for Sigma Gold strategic plan. And along that front, we know that our service initiatives, because that is our focus, we are a premier service organization focusing on the needs of our community. And our service initiatives have been amped up along those lines to support as we approach our centennial. As an example, we just held our national convention 2 weeks ago in Dallas, Texas. We call it our Boule. And at that Boule, as an example of our demonstration of supporting the communities where we reside and serve, we donated more than $87,000 to charitable organizations during our Boule in Dallas, Texas.
Wow.
Yeah, $87,000.
Excellent.
Some of those organizations that benefited, again, back to our being intentional about what we're doing, since we were in Dallas, our theme was to focus on HBCUs, and we actually conducted a day of service at Paul Quinn College, which is an HBCU in Dallas. That college is located in an area that is a federally recognized food desert. There are no grocery stores or fresh vegetables within 20 miles of the university. And so, can you believe that, in 2018? So we focused our efforts on Quinn College.
Yes.
And what Paul Quinn College national president did that came on board about 7 or 8 years ago, he decided to scrap the football team, which was a losing team, and turn his football field into a garden.
Wow, isn't that wonderful?
Yes. So what has happened out of that is the university, on several fronts that they're meeting, which really aligns with the mission of Sigma Gamma Rho, what they're doing is, with that particular community garden, the students actually work the farm. It's really a farm. It's not even a garden. It's a farm. They actually have chickens and roosters on this farm. They grow organic vegetables on this farm. They have a greenhouse. They have tractors. all of this that they have built over the last few years on the farm. So the sorority, while we were there and the affiliates in Dallas 2 weeks ago, we spent several hours on the farm and we actually planted. Yes, we got out there, rolled up our
skirts. Isn't that wonderful?
Planted. We worked the farm that day, as well as, of course, taking a tour of everything that's going on at Paul Quinn College's farm. And their farm is called We Over Me, which means the community is more important than ourselves. If we're not giving back to the communities, what are we doing? How are we making our indelible mark of our space
right.
here on this earth? So a great right. title for the farm. So the president, Mark Soros, was great. He, you know, greeted us when we arrived there at the farm. We worked the farm that day. And then we also decided, because the farm is covering so many components, the students work the farm as a part of work study to reduce their student debt. The
mm-hmm.
students then also work the produce that they have. They have a produce sale every week where they actually open it up to the community to come and buy fresh
yeah.
vegetables. And then they also donate a sizable amount of the fresh vegetables to the community where the college sits.
That is so needed. And
it
that
is awesome.
So wonderful. Yes,
yeah.
that is awesome.
And
what is the name of the college again?
Paul Quinn College.
All right.
And because of their efforts, we wanted to make sure that we supported, because they were very much aligned with our mission and our purpose of providing educational opportunities, again, through the students working the farm to reduce student debt, also providing mm-hmm. food back to the communities in a federally recognized food desert, and then being able to support the education component, because the students who work the farm also have to create a business plan of how they're going to sell and market the fresh vegetables that they grow. So it's so many components of education, you know, giving back to the community. And so what the sorority did was we gave $22,000 to Paul Quinn College for their farm. And the number 22 is meaningful to us because we were founded in 1922. So we donated $22,000 to Paul Quinn College 2 weeks ago while we were in Dallas.
Remarkable and wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Go Sigma Gamma Rho.
It didn't stop there with our focus on HBCUs. We then decided to join partnership with the National Education Fund, the NEF Foundation, and we had a wobble moment. The song
wow.
wobble, that everyone likes to dance to. We took time out of our business session, and we wobbled for 15 minutes. And during that 15 minutes, in order to wobble, you
I'll
had to
be,
donate.
I'll be good at that, Sara. I'll be good at it.
You had to donate to the to our HBCU focus. So in partnership with the NEF, Sigma Gamma Rho, in 15 minutes, raised, while we were wobbling, $25,022 in 15
Go,
minutes.
Go, Sigma Gamma Rho. Wonderful,
yeah.
wonderful.
Yes. Yeah, that happened during our convention in Dallas 2 weeks ago as well, while we were together.
And I was going to ask you, how many members do we have currently internationally?
Sigma Gamma Rho is approaching over 100,000 members internationally. And we have several opportunities to expand. We're looking now at some chapters continuing to grow our sisterhood outside of the U.S., and we're excited about that space as well to extend our reach.
Whew, this is some good stuff, some really, really good stuff. I tell you what, I have a song that we queued up, and it's by Kelly Price, and it's called You Brought the Sunshine, and she's doing it with the Clark Sisters, getting some of that gospel music in the mix here, and I want to dedicate that song to you, Sara Smith, and all Saras everywhere of Sigma Gamma Rho. Let's listen to Kelly Price. You brought the sunshine along with the Clark Sisters.
Y'all ain't ready. Oh, once again, Kelly Price, the fabulous Clark Sisters.
You made my day.
You put a smile on
We're back, Source Nation, and my special guests are in the spotlight with Teresa Hannah, Sarah Deborah Catchings-Smith, International Grand Basileus of Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority. All right. I am just so elated that you took the time out of your busy, busy schedule to come and to speak with us. I'm going to read our vision statement. It says, "We visualize a world in which all women and their families reach their full potential in all aspects of life and are able to create unlimited opportunities for future generations." And would you just comment just a little bit on that for me, Sarah Smith?
Yes, absolutely. At the end, where it all matters is what we are doing to help others, and that is the magnanimous foundation of our sisterhood, and that is to ensure that we are creating opportunities, we are supporting our neighborhoods and our families, our women and children, and that we are giving back in a way that matters and makes a difference, and we're also empowering our community to also get engaged, whether it be through social action or community service or education. There is so much work out here that can be accomplished. It only takes one person, just one mm-hmm. person getting engaged to help and mentor a young person, a young boy or young girl, can make all
that's
the
right.
difference in someone's life, you know. And so that is really the thriving focus of our amazing sisterhood, our membership, our sisterhood, our leaders on the local, regional, and national levels are fully engaged in that mission and that effort, and they execute every day against that mission to make a difference. And I am so proud of all of them.
And I am, too, and so proud of you also, Sarah, for your leadership. Also, speaking about and focusing on challenges, one came to the Sarahs of Sigma Gamma Rho in the Harrisburg, Pennsylvania chapter. They were questioned by a state trooper while engaged in an adopt-a-highway community service activity, almost like, you know, stopping them from doing their work. They had put in all the paperwork. They were supposed to be there, but yet some things happened. But you took leadership and the reins, and you released a statement. Kind of comment on that situation for our audience.
Sure. The premise, you know, again, of the national organization is that we want to ensure that our members are protected in all that they do. You know, they're U.S. citizens, specifically to the U.S. scenario, being citizens of this nation and giving back to the community through a service project. We want to make sure that they feel that they are safe in that space when we're going out, because we do so much work in the communities across the country of the United States specifically.
Mm-hmm.
And we just
mm-hmm.
want to ensure that we're supporting our sisterhood and
that's
our
right.
that they go out in the communities, they can feel safe with the work that they are doing. So absolutely, we stand in support of our sorors.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I know, too, that one of the things that Sigma, you know, definitely is concerned about is anti-racism, and we're committed to identifying those issues that may arise when it concerns race and color and its impact on our members and others. Comment a little bit on that, Sarah.
Yes, absolutely. That continues to be a great focus and work in our nation, and even more so today with our current climate. And we do have a social action arm of our sisterhood that has been deployed for several years. And actually, you know, their efforts, of course, have been stepped up, again, based on the climate of our nation that we are currently experiencing today. And we have sorors on the ground engaged
basically
all kinds of matters that support, you know, Voting Rights Act. We have a partnership with the national MPAC as well as the NAACP. To get folks registered, to make sure not only are they registered, but also that they go to the polls once they're registered, and before they go to the polls, to ensure that they are educated on the issues so that they are clear about what it is they're voting for or what they're voting against. And so
that's
we
right.
have a great partnership with the NAACP that's underway as we speak, as we, you know, move into the midterm elections in November. But also we want to ensure that everyone understands politics is local. It starts at the local level. Who's on your school board?
Mm-hmm.
Who are you electing as your sheriff? Who are you electing as your local representatives, whether it be aldermanic ward or other representatives in your town, your city, whether it be your state reps, your governor,
that's
your
right.
mayor? Politics is very local. It just doesn't start at the cultural level. Because what we're seeing over time is that a lot of these activities that are going on that are attacking such things as voter rights acts are happening at the state level. It's not the federal level. So we have to make sure we are providing the consistent education to all people in our communities about the fact that it is so important to be engaged on the local level first and go out and vote on the local level and use your and exercise your power of your voice through the electoral ballot to ensure you're electing people that represent your interests.
That's right. Absolutely. Sarah, I know our time is running out because you've got to go, but I don't want to let you go until you tell us a little bit about your visit now. You're in Santa Ana, California. You're doing something special, some special business for Sigma Gamma Rho. Can you tell us about that?
Yes, absolutely. I'm glad to be here in Santa Ana, California. I am attending the USA Swimming Phillip 66 National Swimming Championship. And this National Swimming Championship is poised to help assist our USA team, USA swimmers, our athletes, that will represent our country in 2020 at the Summer Olympics.
Wow.
And,
great.
Yeah, so I'm poised to be here for that. But bigger than that is we do have a national partnership with USA Swimming, which I mentioned earlier, and that is our drowning prevention-focused program called Swim
Yes.
in 22. And so just to have an opportunity to engage the leadership here with USA Swimming, and USA Swimming is the umbrella organization for all of our Olympic athletes that compete in the Olympics representing the United States. And so USA Swimming organization has over 440,000 members, and it is just an honor that Sigma Gamma Rho is the first national service organization, the first international sorority, and the first Divine Nine organization to ever partner with USA Swimming to tackle drowning prevention.
We are number one.
Yes. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful.
Yes, yes.
Okay, okay. I am going to release you before I release you to go to finish your very, very busy day. Give us some final comments, please. And for those who want to contact the national, international organization, how can they do that? For further information. Or there's some people out there who want to help us to sponsor some things.
Absolutely, absolutely. So I just want to conclude first by thanking you, Sor Hannah, for this amazing opportunity to come on to address Source Nation. This has been awesome to share knowledge and information about Sigma Gamma Rho. Maybe some have heard of us. Others may have not been aware of the great work and the focused service that we're doing in our community. So thank you so much for allowing me to share our story. The focus continues to remain on our sisterhood to be impactful, to measure our outcomes so that we can ensure we are addressing the needs of our community. We have an international website, and that is www.sgrho1922.org, and that is where information can be obtained, more information about our sisterhood, as well as the contact information to our international corporate headquarters, which is located in Cary, North Carolina.
Sarah Deborah Catchings-Smith, thank you so much for being my guest on In the Spotlight with Teresa Hannah for Source Nation. We are just elated that you dropped by to enlighten our world and also give those who are wanting to make a difference an opportunity to do that through our beloved sorority, Sigma Gamma Rho. Thank you so much, Sarah.
Again, I appreciate you and this great opportunity to share the story of Sigma Gamma Rho. Thank you so much for everything. You have a great weekend.
All right. God bless you. Source Nation, Sigma Gamma Rho, we're soaring to great heights of attainment around the world, and we continue to grow through our sisterhood, our scholarship, and our service. And we want you, yes, we want you to join us in these great goals as a sorrow, follow, rower, business partner, or friend as we knock down those negative challenges that face the human race and as we strive toward perfection of the good life in the blessings of God for all humanity. So
So, Source Nation, also we want to leave you with this fun song by hip-hop pioneer and Sarah MC Light. And the song is called Cha-Cha-Cha, and I want to say Cha-Cha-Cha. Y'all have a wonderful day, and God bless you real good. And I love you, love you, love you.
Kicking cha-cha-cha to this Mardi Gras. I'm the dopest female that you've heard thus far. And I do get better, the voice gets wetter. Nobody gets hurt,
as long as you let her.
Do my thing with an 89 swing. The dopeness, I write a guaranteed delight. Until the hip-hop maniac, the uptown brainiac in full effect, MC Light is back. And better than before, as if that was possible. My competition, you'll find them in the hospital. Visiting time, I think it's on a Sunday. But notice, they only get one day to shine. The rest of the week is mine. And I'll blind you with the signs that the others have yet to find. So come along and I'll lead you the right way. Just clap your hands to the words I say. Come on. Kick, kick. For me and my DJ.
I got the power to spit out and devour at the same time. I'll eat you up with a rhyme, but I'll let you slide because you accidentally hopped on the wrong side. Now come on, that's suicide. Hypothetically speaking, okay, let's say you didn't know what you were doing. You're new in town and you're looking around for another name to ruin. And it's me that you're pursuing? Well, well, well. I'll be damned, I might as well tell you who I am. I am the capital L-Y-T-E, and it's shocking, I'm the one you're mocking. Oh yes, I've been watching you, watching me, and like the fat on your back, it's plain to see that you're a wannabe, but you can't be what you're not, so you better start living with what you got. Kick, kick this one here for me and my DJ. J.K. Rock, let me hear a scratch. Now it's time to kick a rhyme out the patch. And you're the receiver, eager as a beaver. Time to convert the non-believer that I'm a roadrunner, leaving you in the dust. I can't adjust to the times, and at times I might just get quicker than the ticker of your pacemaker. More tender than a roadie, but harder than a jawbreaker. So don't ever second guess me. And if you're wondering who could the best be, think a second and recollect the worst whipping you ever had yet. And I'll bet that I did it. My fingerprints are still on you. How many times I gotta warn you about the light? It'll blind your sight, but the rhythm will still guide you through the night. Kick, 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 kick. Kick, 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 kick.
Here's your host, let's go. If you wanna be in the know, in the spotlight is where to go. Industry celebrities of every kind. Teresa Hannah, your host, let's go. In the spotlight, the spotlight, the spotlight, the spotlight, in the spotlight, the spotlight, with Teresa Hannah. Hannah is your host, let's go. If you wanna be in the know, in the spotlight is where to go. Industry celebrities of every kind. Teresa Hannah, your host, let's go. In the spotlight, the spotlight, the spotlight, the spotlight, in the spotlight, the spotlight, with Teresa Hannah.